Vicki King. I retired to Indiana in 2014. It's taken me this many years to figure out the Indiana system. festival. We lived in, this is my husband Tom, we lived in Tennessee for 26 years. And I was involved in the Federated Festival there. I was the festival chairman for 15
Excuse
years.
Excuse me, can she please speak up a little bit?
I was the festival chairman for 15 years. And so all the 25 years that I was involved in the festival, we used this form that will be used now in Indiana. This is the national form. It's in your packet on the very last, it's the very last page. This is the state, this is the national form, the JR39 form that has been used for years. Before we do that, let me say that anyone who is a festival chairman deserves a crown in heaven. It's a lot of work, but I think that of all the stuff that we do in the Federation, the most important thing is our junior festivals, because the junior festivals are where we are visible. It's about the children. It's about making music viable for our children. It's about making making sure that those children have a wonderful experience. It's not about how many gold cups we can accumulate. It's about making music. It's about promoting American composers. That book with the all of the junior festival music in there, I know those composers. I know many of those composers personally. Many are friends of mine. And I take it very seriously when teachers come in with Xerox music, because they're taking money from the mouths of these composers. It is illegal, and we must not have that happen. In your packet that I've given you, all of these forms are downloaded, can be downloaded from the website. The wonderful thing I heard somebody talking about, filling out forms, how we fill out forms. The beauty of filling out forms on the website is you can do it electronically. You can go in there. I remember in the old days with my 20 students, I had to write in everybody's name and everybody's information. But on the website, you download the form, you can type in the information. The JR38 form is the application, the official application. And I really think that everybody should fill this form out. I know you have your electronic ways of doing things, but this is important, mainly because it helps your festival chairman understand this child. The date of birth is important. Because, for example, in the pre-primary section, children can stay in that pre-primary area until they're 7 years old. And say you're the festival chairman, and a child is in the pre-primary section, and you look at the date of birth, and they're 8 years old, then you can catch that quickly and tell the teacher, you have
been in pre-primary. They can be no more than 8 years old.
Okay, but say that they put the wrong date, put the date on there. You as the festival chairman can catch that quickly and say you really need to go up and do that. There are all kinds of things. As festival chairman, I would look at these applications, and one of the teachers would put the required composition. Fine, it was in the book. They put the choice composition, which was from the Little Method book. It was an arranged piece. Our rules are it cannot be an arranged piece. The teacher had goofed. I called her up and I said, quickly, turn in a different piece. You haven't followed the rules. We want the child to make sure they have a good experience. You don't want them to get to the festival and say, oh, you can't do this. You're disqualified. So it's about making sure that the children good experience. When I was working on my doctorate, my teacher, my major professor said to me, Vicki, when you judge, you rate high and you write a lot of constructive criticism. And I have used that as my mantra. I judge for MTNA, I judge for Guild, I judge for Federation, and I always write tons and tons, tons and tons. And what I try to do is reinforce what that teacher is teaching. And if, for example, if a child doesn't have very good rhythm, and I take off for the rhythm, I'll say, your teacher has asked you to do this correctly. And the teacher will say, you know, that judge said this. So, and I've been telling you, the child said, well, if the judge said it, it must be right. So you're there to help the teacher. The judge is there. So anyway, here's the first form, JR3A. Filling it out, the information, so that the festival chairman knows all this. The festival chairman needs to know, are they from another state? Have they been in a Gold Cup plan? Just this kind of information. But at the bottom, the teacher signs it saying, I have not photocopied any music. And that, I think, is very important, that a festival chairman have that. Looking at JR35, this talks about the ratings, because Indiana has used other ratings. These are the 5 ratings. And superior to me is, as I instruct my judges, a superior is like an A at school. It's not perfect. A lot of teachers will say, or judges will say, it's superior. That, it's not really superior. That's just the rating, but it means an A. It's a 91 to 100. It means that, it doesn't mean that it's perfect, but it means that it's really, it's obvious this child has prepared. This child has gotten details. Okay, they make 2 or 3 mistakes over here, but it doesn't mean that you should give them a lower grade. Excellent, quite frankly, when I judge, I rarely give anything except superior or excellent, because I think this child has worked all year on this festival, and if I give them a satisfactory, that is so defeating for that child. So if they make a lot of mistakes, I generally do an excellent, but that's just the way I do it. I'm always positive. I always talk about the good things that they do. So in instructing your judges, the festival chairman, what the festival chairman has to do is a lot of stuff. Receiving all these applications, arranging the place, arranging the schedule, getting the judges and instructing the judges. And the chairman can determine about how that festival will go, how those judges are thinking. And keep the judges positive. Tell them, make the children feel comfortable. Try out the piano. Fix the stand. Say something to them. We always say, you can't talk to the judges, but a judge can talk to a child and say, please come in and have a friendly face. So there is that. Okay, then, looking at the back of the second page, JR36. How many of you use, in your festival, do you use, have one judge? We have one judge. How many have two? Okay.
For duets, we always.
All right. Anyway, this chart, JR36, tells you if you have two judges, how do you determine that the rating of, if you've got, and so there's a chart there that you can use that, to determine the rating. The important one, look at the very back, on the back of the packet. That is specific as to the ratings. Let's look at that. What is a superior? Outstanding performance, consistently musical, stylistically correct, accurate, good dynamics, phrasing, and musical expression, a complete performance. It doesn't mean that there are not mistakes, but it's obvious that this person has prepared. Excellent, strong performance. Performance shows accomplishment, good potential, but rhythm, discrepancies in rhythm, dynamics, and phrasing. When I judge and give an excellent, it's usually because there are no dynamics. There are rhythm mistakes, maybe memory slips. Satisfactory has a lot of errors. Fair, if a child is at a fair level, a teacher should probably never let that child even be in the festival. If they're at that level where they can barely get through their piece, the teacher should make some kind of judgment and just say to the child, I think we shouldn't do this year, rather than have them go in there and play for a judge and do a poor performance. We want the children to have good performances. We want them to have a good experience. Now, turn back to the JR39. This is the form that the judges will use. And
the students should never see this.
Huh?
The students should not see the 39A. That's just for the judges.
That's for the judges, too. That's to give them some guidelines.
And the 3-6.
Because if the judge is trying to say, oh, well, should I give them an excellent or superior? Now, what I do on the JR39, the teacher will fill this form out online, and you fill out the name of the child. The judge does not need to know. The judge should not know the name of the teacher. They should not know who the teacher is. In fact, when I would judge, I could always recognize the teacher's handwriting, really. But nowadays, you can do it online. You type it in the computer. So when you spit this thing out, nobody knows who the teacher is. So all the judge is going to see is this form. This is all. The judge sees this. The judge sees this. The child's music, which should belong to the child and not to the teacher. It's obvious to me sometimes I see teachers coming in lugging a suitcase of music to a festival, which tells me the children have been using Xerox copies. Why should the teacher lug the music to the festival?
Sure,
the teacher shouldn't come do anything except be there and smile at the children, and the child comes in with their music. Anyway, the children come in with their music, and they come in with the measures numbered, which I don't know if that's in any rules, but it sure is a convenience for the judge.
It is in the rules.
Oh, yeah.
It's in our rules.
And so then the judge looks at this, the required composition, the choice composition, and when I'm judging, first thing I'm doing, I'm listening to the music, and I go through, I'm listening to it, and I go through down on my, say the required piece. You say to the child, which piece would you like to do first? Friendly judge. Which piece would you like to do first? Oh, I'd like to do so-and-so, which is the choice piece. So then they look at the choice column. So I'm listening to this, and I quickly will look in the choice column, and I'm writing, memory, excellent. And I jot plus at a few of these things. Or I look and I think, aha, their beat is not steady. And I put a quick minus there. And so then I write over in the right-hand column, over where it says judge's remarks, I make a comment. I look at all those plus things that I have given that child, and I say, I love the way you sit at the piano. I love the way you've got wonderful correct notes. Your dynamics were excellent in measure, so and so and so. But you want to watch your beats were not steady in measure 14 and 15. And then the child thinks, my teacher told me the very same thing. Question.
For these pluses and minuses, does each column, each category in each column have to have all the pluses and minuses?
No. For example, I'm a piano judge. I don't say a thing about
breath control.
We had a judge last year who was judging piano. And she said, oh, your breath control is wonderful. Okay.
So what about things like correct notes? Do we have to have a plus or minus?
You don't.
Notes?
You do not.
What if it's it's kind of correct but not great? Because you don't want to give them a plus if it's okay but not great.
Can you give them a plus minus?
No.
Or is it
no.
So
you don't
just leave
a plus
it blank.
Or minus.
Either a plus or a minus.
You can leave it blank.
You can leave it blank.
Okay.
That's just because then what's going to happen is some teachers, some judges will say, they'll say plus, 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 all pluses, and write a couple of comments, and then they'll say, excellent. And the teacher thinks, well, why did they get an excellent?
Right.
She wrote all
right.
pluses.
Right.
So the judge has to justify.
Mm-hmm.
If they give them an excellent, children don't want excellence. They want superiors.
Mm-hmm.
But if they get an excellent, well, why did I get an excellent? Why did I get one? She gave me all pluses.
Mm-hmm.
So that's important to tell the judge, justify what you have, the rating you've given. You cannot give an excellent plus. You cannot give a superior minus. You've got to make the decision. Superior? Is it superior or is it excellent? Now, I have had judges do this. They will say this, for example, the required piece, they had plus, plus, plus. So many good things in that column. But then the choice composition, they had several minuses. So they said, what do I do? I've got a bunch of minuses over here. I've got a bunch of pluses over here. That's just the judge's decision. You've got to make a decision. If you think that maybe they are having problems with rhythm in general, if it's something, a problem that should be addressed, then perhaps they should have an excellent. So that the pluses and minuses are just to give you, as you're going through to judge, give you some ideas about various little things. For example, if I'm judging, I always, of course, I look for hand position. That's my big thing. Pedal, you know, some little kids aren't using pedal. Fingering, body position, dynamics. I always look for dynamics. Sometimes I don't do plus or minus on phrasing. Marked expression, same thing as dynamics usually. Memory, I always put memory. Say the child's struggling with memory and on both pieces, minuses, but I'll allow them to play it. But obviously if they're having memory problems, they're not gonna get a superior. And so then when I do my remarks, I write a lot and I write specific remarks. I don't just say, thank you for playing, it was a very good performance. I never say that. I say, I like the way you played your dynamics in measure 15. You had a very good retard in measure 16. You had the fermata that you had in measure 42 needs to be longer. So I was very specific. So if these kids are paying their $10 and the judge is judging, they need to get their money's worth. The teacher needs to get the money's worth. The teacher has worked all year to prepare all of these kids, and if some judge comes back and says, very good, superior, well, you know, what good is that? But I would like to, I would keep all of my sheets from every year, from all the different judges, and look at all the different comments. And then I'd go over with my students after the festival. I'd say, now look, let's go through these. And then we're playing another thing in a month. We can try these judges' ideas and improve. So it's more than just about getting a cup. It's about helping that judge is going to help that student and reinforce that teacher. So anyway, any questions about this?
I have a question. Now I know that we've done this kind of for our festival, but we due to the different instruments, or you know, vocal,
uh-huh.
piano, instrumental, sight reading, we've got some different forms that we have made. Like we have like a vocal judging, we've had a vocal judging sheet,
uh-huh.
a piano judging sheet, instrumental and sight reading,
uh-huh.
Because of course you're not gonna, if somebody's singing or playing the piano, you're not gonna need the use of bow or
yeah,
tonguing,
sure.
But you're gonna want like, there's other things in here that you're like, you know, that might be used. Do we need to use this universally and
yes.
just, or?
Yes,
or
you use this universally. Everybody
so
uses
So every
this
single
form.
Instrument
sight
will be
too,
used.
Everything.
It's
exactly.
for everything.
Because we've had, in Indiana, we had several festivals who had used different forms, and National called us out on it. This
okay.
is, this has.
So you're gonna have to use comments.
Yeah,
yeah.
Use comments
okay.
for those
necessary.
Other specific things.
So
you know,
yeah, so if it's like use of bow, you just kind of put a, like, line through it, or like, you're not gonna put it.
You don't even have to bother with that.
Yeah.
You don't ignore it.
You just don't do
but
that.
But it'll
line.
Apply for, I mean, this is even the form that you're supposed to use for a site plan. But not improvisation.
But the thing is, if you're doing voice, you can have all kinds of things.
Breath of addiction. Yeah.
You've got correct notes. Mm-hmm. You've got memory. You've got marks of expression, note size.
Those things all apply to no matter what it is.
All, everything.
Right.
This covers everything.
I was just looking at technique and realized that there's like three things that apply to.
But you don't use those. You don't use those.
Okay.
You use what applies to your particular thing.
Okay.
This is a general thing. You do not check. Let me reinforce that. You do not check everything on this thing, on the list. But you can use it. For pluses and minuses are things that are particularly outstanding. If I'm a vocal judge and somebody's got really excellent breath control, I'm going to put plus under that column over there. Okay. And if their diction is excellent, or say their diction
those
is poor,
are being used.
The diction is poor, I put a minus there.
Right.
But I don't check every column. I don't put plus and minuses in every column. I just do a few that apply to me, and I don't do every one.
So I would want to know, like, I don't know. I guess I would want to know. I would want to have a plus or minus by my breath control. I want to know if my student had proper breath control or if they didn't during the performance. So I would hope that if they're going to be making comments, that they would use the ones that would apply to that, whether or not.
You instruct your judges, say, use those plus and minuses. So that the teachers, because you write a few comments, but then the teachers can look at that and see specifically where their strengths are, where their weaknesses are. They can see that immediately. And then as a judge, I go back through and I say, oh my gosh, well, there are four minuses. Or those people didn't have good diction in either piece. And their memory was not good. I don't think I can give them a superior in my heart of hearts. And then you address that, but you also, as a judge, please write some positive things.
Oh yeah.
If you're going to give somebody an excellent. So anyway, any other questions?
Yeah.
Okay.
So both this rating sheet and the application sheet are online. You can go in and fill them all out. And you just print them out for your own. I mean, this isn't going into they're not going forward onto state or anything. So it's just for our own information, kind of, that we go to that web. It's just easier than printing.
And you can say,
I've got an item when we cover festivals. I've got an item that is going to address that little thing and just, you know.
So
okay.
You don't have to.
Questions?
Anything
else? Okay.
I have a question. Do you have the chairs type all this, or does every individual teacher type up these forms for all of their own events and then turn
them
in?
The teacher types up the form. The teacher types up the rating sheets.
So it looks like you have to type two things now for every, because in the past we only have,
this is how you track everything, though. Wouldn't this be a new event sheet?
That's your chore.
Okay.
So I know. It's a chore to do it by hand. Somebody said a while ago, I think Lisa said, we only have to do this one. But according to what I've done in the past, we always had that application form because of the signature about the Xerox music.
But here's the thing, like we are all electronic, so we already have all this information. It's not on this sheet, but it's all.
I didn't realize that you were. Yeah. All right, but how do you get the teacher to sign? I have not used photocopy music.
I have a separate form for them.
Okay. Okay, then that's fine. Then to answer your question, then just do the application. Then if you have it electronically,
I'm going to address that.
Well, I don't think
okay.
they do. But,
okay.
Okay. All right.
Any questions?
Vicki, thank you so much
okay.
for taking time to present.
I got people's big heads in the way.